What is the importance of card chart in Power BI? Hi, I am M. Asif Hussain from Know-How Academy. In this video, we are going to see what is a card chart and how many different types of card charts we have and why is card chart a very important in a report in Power BI. Here I have a Power BI desktop with a data set with multiple columns in it. If we look into the importance of card chart, I can call it as an important for the reason that a card chart will give us a very clear information about any specific value. It will give us a very clear information about any specific individual information, such as how many customers I have, how much total sales I have got in my business, what is the total cost, what is the total profit, and how many regions I have, how many categories I have, how many states I have, who is my first customer, who is my last customer. All these kind of specific informations we can get it in a card chart. Always remember, we can define card chart in a way that a card chart is used to show a specific key value. So in any report you take, in any dashboard you take of a Power BI, there will be minimum 4 to 5 card charts for sure. Obviously, if we use these kind of card charts in our report, it will give us a very clear idea to the client. It will give us a very clear idea to the customer. It will give us a very clear idea to all the viewers who are looking into our dashboard or report about the specific values. So let us start working on it. So I am taking a card chart. In this card chart, let me show you step by step how we can go with it. In this card chart, let me first choose a category as a column information. So I know that there are multiple categories that I have, but here when I drag a category value here in a card chart, it is showing me the furniture as a category. And if you consider the category label, we have the category label as first category. As per the alphabetical order, the first category that it is considering as furniture. But there are different types of card charts that I have. Let me show it to you. So this is a card chart and it is showing me the first category as a furniture. Now, if I click on a arrow drop down arrow mark here, I have an option to choose my last category, which is technology. Now, you might have a question. There might be multiple. How should I find it? You know, here we can go and see there is a difference. There is something called as a count and count distinct. A very, very important interview question. What is the difference between count and count distinct? Count will give us the repeated values. Count distinct, it will consider only the unique values and will give us the answer. For example, we are going into a supermarket. There in a supermarket, I being Asif Hussain, I'll go there today. I'll go there tomorrow. I'll go there on Wednesday. I go there on Thursday. I go there on Friday. I again go there on Saturday. And I will again go there on Sunday. So I am alone. I am going 7 times in a week, one day, each time I'm going into a supermarket. Now, if I see the backend part of my database of a supermarket, if I look into it, so how should they consider? They should consider that I got 7 customers, or should they consider that we got only 1 customer who came 7 times? So that is the difference. Count will tell us that we got 7 customers, but count distinct will tell us that we got only 1 customer, but that 1 customer, he came 7 times to our supermarket. That is the difference between count and count distinct. So if I want to see how many genuine categories that I have without repeated, so for that, I should go and see my count distinct. I have only 3 categories. But if I look into the count, there are these 3 categories. They are, you know, repeated multiple times, 9,994 times. Okay, so this you have to consider when we are showing some information, we should show the genuine information. All right. Now, let me take another card chart. And let me show you. I'll drag the numerical data, which is profit here. So my total profit that I have got is 286.40K. If I again take another card chart, in this card chart, I am going to take my sales. How much sales I got? 2.3 million sales I got. Let me convert the millions unit into thousands here. I will convert the value from millions to thousands. So 2297.20K are my total sales of my business. Now, how should I consider what is my average sales? So how should I do that? Click on this arrow mark and click on average. So the average sales that we have got is 0.23K. Now, how should I see what is my minimum sales? My minimum sales is 0.00K. So everything, all those arithmetical aggregation that we have, so we can get it here. If I go with maximum, the maximum sales that I have, it is 22.64K. In the same way, if we look into the profit, so the average profit that I got is 28.66 is my average profit. Now, if I go with the minimum profit, my minimum profit is minus 6, which is a negative. Okay, if I would like to go with my maximum profit, it is 8.40K is my maximum profit. So this is how we can calculate the average, minimum, maximum. We can even find the count distinct repeated values, unique values, information using a card chart. Now, let me even show you. I would like to see there are multiple customers that I have in my business. Out of all those customers, I would like to see who is my first customer in my whole data set that I have. I should see who is my first customer. How should I do that? Click on a card chart. Then you drag the customer name column into the card chart. So my first customer is Aaron. My first customer in my whole data set is Aaron. Now, if I want to see who is my last customer is someone here. Okay. So why am I getting Aaron as first? We can get some other name, right? So the point here is that Power BI, when we are loading a data set into Power BI, it will consider the alphabetical order way. In the same way we have got it here. We have different types of categories. If I show it to you, we have, let me show the category column here. So under category, we have three types of categories: furniture, office supplies, and technology. If we consider the alphabetical order, furniture F is taking the first place, second place is for office supplies, and the third place is for technology. That's why we got the last category as technology and first category as furniture. Now, in the same way, I have got my last customer, first customer. I would like to see how many total customers I have in my particular data set. How should I see that? If I click on count, I am getting 9,994 customers. Is it correct? Do I really have 9,994 total customers in my data set? Yes or no? This is very important question that you have to think about yourself. Okay, when I'm showing some value in a report to my client or customer, we should make sure that the value that we are showing is correct or not. 9,994 total customers, really, do I really have it? Let us cross verify. I'm going and click on count distinct. We have only 793 customers, but these 793 customers were repeated. That's where we got 9,994 as our total customers. So there is a lot of difference between count and count distinct, which we need to be careful when we are showing the values in a card chart in a report or a dashboard. So this is how we can use a card chart. Card charts are very important to understand the business very easily. So total sales, we have got it in one go. We had came to know that, okay, this is my total sales. We can show average sales. We can show total customers, total categories, total states. So this is how the importance of card chart lies when we are using a report or a dashboard. In the same way, you might have one important question. Sir, you are showing only one information in a card chart. Is it possible that can I add another value to the card chart? For example, I have considered the sales, which is 2297.20k as my sales in card chart. Including the sales, I should even show what is my profit. Okay, so if I would like to drag profit and keep it in the place, I will get it get replaced. It is getting replaced. We cannot keep two values in one single card chart. We cannot keep two different values. We cannot drag two different columns in one single card chart. In a single card chart, only one single key value is allowed. We can get only one specific column. That is very important point to be noted. Now, you might have a question. If I would like to show more than one information, for example, I would like to show two informations, two columns, three columns, or four values, different values, I would like to show it, which card chart I have to use. So for this, Power BI has come up with another card chart, that is multi-row card chart. Okay, we have seen the card chart, which is a simple card chart. But now let us see some card chart called as multi-row card chart. There will be different rows in a card chart. Multi-row card chart. Now if we see here, we have a multi-row card chart. Now let me drag all those informations that we have seen just now. First, we have taken category, so I'll drag category. Then let me drag the customer names. So if you see here, Aaron, he opted for furniture. Again, Aaron Hawkins, he opted for furniture. So which customer opted for which particular category, we can see it here. Now I would like to show the sales. So for each customer, for each category, how much sales we have got. In the same way, I would like to show profit also. So for each category, for each customer, how much sales we have got and how much profit we have got, that is also visible here. So more than one information, if you would like to show, then we can go with a multi-row card chart. But in a single card chart, only one key value is allowed to show in a report or a dashboard. We can use multi-row card chart to show more than one information as part of a row basis. Please have a note that the multi-row card chart, we are getting the values in the form of a row basis. So that's where multi-row card chart plays an important role. So we can get the more than one values in a multi-row card chart, and we can show only one key value, one specific number in a card chart. So these are the two different types of card charts that we have in Power BI. There is another new type of card chart that has come in Power BI in a new upgradation. So in that, we can add two values simultaneously in a new card chart that we have, that we will see it later on. So this is how we can use a card chart and multi-row card chart in Power BI desktop. So thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source for IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate the tech world. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out. It's been a pleasure sharing this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.